Hello and welcome to our third tutorial on Urban Design Software Tool Modeler. In this video, we'll be talking about two ways on how to create simple modular buildings. The first and most basic way is by creating default building, which means three things. First, it will be created at default location, which is the origin of SketchUp model coordinate system. Second, it will have default shape, which can be set in options, where you can choose between square, circle and L shape. And third, it will have default height and number of floors, which you can set under default building parameters inside the whole plot tab. Now the simplest way to create a building is to click on yellow icon in Modeler's toolbar. The same happens if you go to Building tab and click Create button, or if you go to Extensions, Modeler, Create Building. In either case, you will be creating default building. But default buildings are not really useful, are they? We want to be able to shape a building according to our needs. So let's try to reshape it so that it will fit the edges of the building in basemap. We just have to move it to the right place and then use scale tool to reshape it. Since Modeler is completely integrated in SketchUp, you can use its default tools. For example, you can scale the height and the Modeler will automatically update number of floors once you finish the scaling. You can also see those changes in Modeler user interface. The second way you can create a building is by first drawing a face and then create a building from it. So let's draw a rectangle, and before we create the building, let's make sure that the face is selected. If nothing is selected, Modeler will just create the default building. But since Modeler automatically selects the face when you draw a rectangle, we just need to click Create Building and that's it. If we want to draw a building of a more complex floor plan shape like this one, we can use Line tool and draw the outline. Now we have a face and we just click Create Building and it's done. We can use Scale tool again to make it as high as the neighboring buildings. In this short tutorial, we've seen two main options of creating buildings with Modeler, which we believe you will be using most of the time. There is also a third way, creating buildings from edge loops, but we will cover it in one of our next tutorials. Thanks for watching, and if you have any questions, please just drop us an email. See you later!